This piece right in my hand is the lightest and lowest density solid in the world.
Even with a small pressure applied by my finger, the aerogel shatters into thousands of pieces and turns to dust. But what's surprising is that if I take those aerogel dusts and apply it to any surface, like my body, it becomes 100% hydrophobic. It makes me completely waterproof. On top of that, this dust also forms new, non-brittle, foam-like aerogel composites, which can be utilized in extreme applications requiring protection.
Aerogels can be in different shapes. Given that they are 99% air, can you guess the kind of sound would an aerogel make? It's like an empty can dropping onto a steel surface. Very metallic.
So aerogel is this really amazing material. It's the lowest thermal conductive solid in existence, or the best insulation in the universe. This is the same stuff NASA uses to insulate spacecraft, like the Mars rovers.
What is it made of?
It's just 99% air. In this case, that other 1% or so is amorphous silica. Pores are only a couple nanometers in thickness. To put that into perspective, the average pore size is around 1/10,000th the width of a human hair.
Oh yeah.
Aerogel's insulation capabilities are not its only remarkable property. It also exhibits both hydrophilic and hydrophobic characteristics.
How is it possible?
Now we're gonna sprinkle some aerogel powder on the water. Notice how the aerogel doesn't sink. It's literally floating on the surface, creating a barrier.
I'll put it in the water. It's in the water now.
Thanks to the aerogel's super hydrophobic properties, the match is still dry and lit.
Wow, it's amazing. The spoon is completely submerged, but it's completely dry. I'm going to put some particles on.
I wonder what would happen if I apply it to my whole body. Would I be waterproof?
Wow. That's pretty cool. That's awesome.
These ball-shaped droplets are not actually touching my hand. There is a layer of aerogel powder between my skin and the water.
Go with my entire hand. Wow. It feels like magic.
Yeah, really is.
But what we will see when I cover my whole body with these particles will blow our minds.
You see the intense heat here? Let's start. Oh my god, this one is half burned already. As you see, this setup was much more effective in terms of protecting this hamburger. And this one is on smoke. You see the difference?
If this insulation is really that good, if you're using it to insulate spacecraft, why isn't it used to insulate everything here on Earth, right? From buildings to apparel. Turns out it has one major problem.
I love that. That's beautiful.
The challenge with aerogel since the beginning of time has been that this stuff is super brittle. And that's what we do at Oros Labs or Solar Core. How do you make it not brittle so that you could use it in whatever application?
So this is the solution you came up with?
That's correct. So this is a closed cell foam combined with aerogel.
Closed cell foams are made from silica substance with a structure consisting of tiny sealed air pockets. Before moving to the flamethrower test and test it on my entire body, we'll make one small trial with this foam.
If that falls, I have to take my hand immediately.
Yeah, I'm quick. You ready?
You can crank it up as much as you want. So, you're seeing the impact on it. So, it's very cold here. I can touch it as much as I want, but here it's also cold, it doesn't keep heat. But this one is hot. It melted, look. Look at the shape of it.
We will test the aerogel shield by heating it to the maximum temperature that propane gas can reach.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Whoa!
I can feel some heat from the side, but nothing from the center. Can you get closer to me?
That's as close as I wanted to get.
I can still touch it.
The average temperature of the flames was around 1,200 degrees Celsius. For those unfamiliar, liquid nitrogen is extremely cold at a temperature of about negative 196 degrees Celsius.
It wouldn't be great if it came in contact with your skin. It would freeze your skin.
Then my hand will be shattered.
That's exactly right.
Before using liquid nitrogen on myself with my aerogel insulated jacket, let's see what this liquid nitrogen can do to something that's not protected by aerogel for comparison. This is the Leidenfrost effect. There's such a great temperature difference between liquid nitrogen and the floor that it literally can't get absorbed. Our next item on the list, a bunch of parsley, but this time, instead of submerging it, we'll directly spray liquid nitrogen on it.
And we're gonna see what happens to this chicken.
Even the bones are shattered. This could be so dangerous then.
That's pretty dangerous.
Behind me, Mike is ready to spray the liquid nitrogen directly at me.
Okay, you guys ready?
Five, okay. Four, three, two, one.
Oh, wow, this is amazing. I don't feel it. Just on my pants because some droplets came to my pants, but that's all right. For my upper body, I don't feel anything.
As you see, this ice is covering the entire lake. I'm going to apply particles of aerogel on my body, get in the water and stay dry.
So no health problems, right?
No.
Okay, feeling okay today?
Yeah.
You've obviously been in the water before, cold water.
Yep.
Okay, perfect. We have everything else set up just in case.
I have a bucket of powdered silica aerogel and I'm evenly covering my whole body with that. Let's see if it can keep me dry even underwater.
I'm completely submerging my body now. I am dry. This is a miracle, guys. Particles are blocking the water coming onto my skin. Still nothing, nothing. Look at my leg. It's in the water for quite some time and it's dry. There are droplets on my leg. Let's get these out of my leg. I don't even feel cold. I don't even need that.
The water was kind of dark and muddy. That's why we couldn't see how my body looked underwater. I will get inside a pool now and you'll see how it actually looks underwater. Aerogel particles cause a thin gray layer because they trapped tiny air bubbles on my body. These air bubbles reflect skylight, giving my skin a shiny silvery appearance. You can notice some of these air bubbles coming off my legs and rise to the water surface. Air on my skin makes me feel lighter in the water.
Completely dry. How is that possible? It's raining heavily now, but I don't get wet. Yeah.
I might be the only person caught in the rain completely covered in hydrophobic aerogel particles.
If you look at it carefully, there are rain droplets on the surface of the pool water. That means rainwater and the pool water never meet. There is a layer of aerogel between pool and the rainwater.
The aerogel powder that I applied onto my body was hydrophobic, but this one is hydrophilic. Watch what happens when I drop water on this aerogel. Think of this like a small sponge. It can absorb 25 times of its weight.
As this type of aerogel can absorb moisture from the air, they are used in museums to protect artifacts or to safely store medicines without exposing them to humidity. Last but not least, aerogel's nanopores are even way smaller than the visible light. The visible light ranges from 380 nanometers to 750 nanometers, while the aerogel's pores are only between 20 to 40 nanometers wide.
Shorter wavelength particles, blues, purples, UV light, get scattered when they hit aerogel, and that's what causes aerogel to look blue. Same reason the sky looks blue, it's called Rayleigh scattering.
When we expose an aerogel to ultraviolet light, which has the shortest wavelengths, it scatters the light better, making the aerogel appear opaque. Now when we switch to infrared light, which has the longest wavelengths of all, it passes right through the aerogel, making it appear completely transparent. When I hold it up to the sky, it looks yellow because it allows longer wavelengths of sunlight, such as yellow and red, to pass through more easily, especially in bright sunlight.
Subscribe to my YouTube channel for more documentaries like this. Ruhi Cenet was here.